code for this subject BT301 life sciences, and basically this subject for your section, I don't know about other sections, for your section is I, right? For section I, there are three instructors, three professors who will be teaching you. So myself, Dr. Amita Barik, and then there are Dr. Monideepa Ghosh, and we have Dr. Surabhi Chaudhary ma'am. Okay, so this entire subject, entire life science subject, has been divided into 6 modules. I guess you all have the syllabus with you. You must have downloaded it from the website, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. So we yes, have ma'am. 6 modules. First is cell biology. Second is biochemistry. Third, microbiology. Fourth, immunology. Fifth is molecular biology. And sixth is bioprocess development. So I have also mentioned the professor's name who will be teaching which subjects. So I will be basically teaching you biochemistry and molecular biology, and microbiology will be shared between me and Dr. Ghosh, and the last module, that is the bioprocess development, would be taught by Dr. Surabhi Chaudhary. Right? Okay. So it might so happen that I might take some Thursday class or my Tuesday class, or Dr. Ghosh might take. Okay, whatever be the thing, we'll be informing you. So it might so happen that biochemistry and as well as cell biology goes simultaneously. So I will be teaching one class in biochemistry and ma'am would be teaching cell biology also. It's not like that I will be first finishing biochemistry and then you will be going to cell biology. Is that okay? Any more doubts regarding these things, class?
No. Okay, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay, very good. So let's start with life science. There are two books for biochemistry which I'll be starting. So I will be starting with biochemistry today. There are two books, Leninger, Principles of Biochemistry. And there is another book, a very good book by Stryer. You can get this book, the soft copies from online also. And also if you are coming back to the institute, you have the copies at our library. You can go through this book. So these are very, very good books. The basics have been very much, very well described in the books. But yes, some of you might get scared, ma'am, bahut mota book and all that. So for those, there are other books also. I will be eventually telling you the names. But these are very good books which have all the information regarding the biochemistry part. I hope, how many of you had biology in your class 11th and 12th?
I had.
You had? I mean,
I had.
Okay, I mean, at least how many? 10 to 20% students had biology? No? Okay, anyways, do not worry if you do not had biology in your class 12. This is not going to be very tough. At least biochemistry, I am assuring you, because it is more of chemistry, little of bio. So I guess all of you had chemistry in your 11th, 12th, so I don't think it will be
anything
for you. Let's start with, this is something I always ask my students. So what is your favorite food? I guess all of you had a good yummy breakfast in the
pani
morning.
Puri.
Pani puri. You had pani puri in the morning? I don't think so. Banana. You had pani puri in the morning?
Aloo paratha. Banana.
Aloo paratha, banana. Apple. Some had healthy food, some had junk food and all that. Okay, good.
This is momo.
Morning. Momo, okay. So I do not have a momo picture.
Ma'am, cereals.
Cereals.
Madam, apple.
Madam, chocolates.
Apple. Chocolates, yeah.
Oatmeal.
Oatmeal, very nice.
Poha.
Poha, wow. Are you from North India?
And pasta.
Yes, ma'am.
That's fine. Okay, no problem. So everyone had good food in the morning, and yeah, so can you just tell me why did I keep this picture over here and I'm asking you your favorite food? What is the correlation between this and your subject?
Now on the right side there are junk foods and on the left side there are healthy food.
Okay, that's healthy for the... and junk food. So how do you classify this as healthy food and how do you classify this as junk food?
Saturated fats.
Ma'am, which has fat more and vitamins and minerals less?
Okay. Oily food.
We should look for balanced diet.
Nutrients.
Less side effects.
Lack of nutrients.
Lack of nutrients. Okay.
trans fat and unsaturated fiber, ma'am.
Okay, so someone entered into the deeper meaning, the saturated and unsaturated fats. Very nice, good. Okay, so you guys, did you join the fitness program yesterday? There was a webinar on fitness program.
Yes, ma'am, 7 to 9.
Yes. So there were some doctors telling about these things, right? About your stress, yes. About your food habits and your exercise and all that. Did you listen to that carefully? Yeah, so that is good. So
holistic level.
Your health. And once you return back to the institute, you will find a green, very green environment over here and you can just utilize it, go for jogging and exercise. Achha. So the reason I shared you this slide is that, you know, if you go into the deeper thing, as someone said that these are junk foods and these are things. But if you look into the composition of this food, if they categorize the composition, so they fall into four different categories, isn't it? Can anyone please tell me what are the categories? Anyone, any idea? What are the food? What are the composition of this food?
Carbohydrates, proteins,
carbohydrates, yes.
Fibers,
vitamin, lipid.
Fat, lipids, okay. Very nice, very good. Yeah, so next time when you are going for this thing, the people will say, okay, should cut down your carbs and all that, go for protein diet, isn't it? When you are going for the healthy things. So we will be studying about these things in details. What are carbs, what are proteins and fats and lipids and many more. So basically, food is composed of four major biomolecules. Let's say we have carbohydrates, as say someone said, we have proteins, we have lipids, fats, and then we have also nucleic acid. Okay, so we will be in biochemistry module, we will be discussing about these four major biomolecules. So this major biomolecules are actually macromolecules. Macromolecules in the sense they are big molecules. So we will be starting with the introduction to this major macromolecules, the four major macromolecules. That is the carbohydrates, proteins, lipids, and the nucleic acids. Yeah. Some introductory slide. So I guess all of you are aware of this, the famous periodic table, which listed the different elements. And I guess some of you must have marked it up also. At least 20 or 30, I mean, 30 elements must have been there in your mind. Right. So here in this periodic table, I have highlighted the top five elements that are present in the human body. So yellow boxes, if you go for the hydrogen, then carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and calcium, these are the top five elements that are present in the human body. The green boxes then represent the second top five elements present in the human body. Let's say sodium, potassium, then we have phosphorus, sulfur, and chlorine. Then we have the blue boxes, which are actually the trace elements that are actually required by the human body. So you can see here magnesium, iron, copper, zinc, etc. And then we have our violet boxes, which are actually the elements that are actually not good for the human body. They are deleterious to the human body. Okay. So now when we are looking for a typical bacterial cell, you know, bacteria. So bacteria are microbes. So
what about the white ones?
Sorry?
Ma'am, what about the white ones?
The white ones, again, they have their own significance and all that. But here we are just listing for whatever are necessary or whatever we need. Okay. So we look into the typical bacterial cell by dividing into the composition wise, then we can see that 70% of a bacterial cell is composed of the water molecules. And rest 30 are actually the chemicals, which are actually the macromolecules, such as polysaccharides, the carbohydrates, proteins, RNA, DNA, phospholipids, ions, small molecules, and etc. etc. Okay. So majority actually, if you know, go for the organic mass that is composed by the macromolecules. Yeah. So what are we going to study in this module? We'll be studying what are macromolecules, why they are important, and a little bit about their metabolism. Okay, so let's start macromolecules. So before we start, there is some major, that is the thing that is common in all the macromolecules things. So there are two reactions which are actually the key key reactions in all the metabolism. You are aware of this: condensation and hydrolysis. Condensation in the sense that it is actually joining two molecules with a release of water molecule. Okay, and in hydrolysis, molecules are actually splitting into two different, two or more like mole molecules, and with the help of water molecules. Okay, so this reaction, I guess all of you are aware of it. So if you look into the how the different molecules are actually creating bigger molecules, so these are the actually key reactions in all the metabolisms, anabolism and catabolism, or you can say that condensation, hydrolysis, reactions. I guess all of you are fine with this. I am going in a good pace or very slowly,
yes, ma'am.
Slowly, quick. It's fine. All
yes,
of you.
Fine. Yes, ma'am. Fine, ma'am.
Can anyone please tell me what is actually common to all macromolecules?
Carbon.
Sorry?
Carbon.
Carbon. Okay.
Hydrogen organic compounds. Hydrogen. Organic compounds all.
But if I tell you, okay, macromolecules are actually also known as polymers, then can you tell me what is the common factor? In general, I'm not telling about the composition. What are macromolecules?
CH2O taken N.
Sure, taken N, that is fine. I have a macromolecule. What is it actually composed of? Macromolecule.
Carbon, hydrogen, monomer.
Water.
Yeah, someone just did it. Yes. Macrom also are the bigger molecules. What are the smaller molecules?
Monomers.
Exactly. That is what I wanted to ask. Yes, sir. So, if you look into this macromolecules, these are bigger molecules, so the bigger chains, they're known as the polymers, and these are made up of what do you say as monomers, which are actually the building blocks. So, small molecules are the monomers joined together to form a big molecule, which is known as a polymer. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So when we are talking about these macromolecules, as we said, carbohydrates, proteins, lipids and all. So what are the monomers? So if we classify carbohydrates, lipids, proteins and nucleic acids, so on the right side we have listed here monomers. So, carbohydrates are actually formed up of monosaccharides. Lipids are formed of fatty acids and glycerols. Proteins are formed of amino acids and nucleic acids are formed up of nucleotides. Okay. So what happens here, I'm telling you from a past experience of correcting the papers of my students. I guess many of you are aware of this who have taken biology fields. Okay, kuch bhi nahi hai, very much basic question. But then again, there are many students who actually, I don't know why they skip or something. This question, if I ask in the exam, I guess that around 60% of students answer it wrong. I don't know why. I have given the slides, I'm doing the recordings and all that, but maybe they are not studying well and all that, but nucleic acid are the macromolecules and nucleotides are the monomers. Clear? Don't get confused. And sometimes they don't write the spellings also properly, because nucleotide spelling always be written something else and all that. So monosaccharides are the monomers of carbohydrates, lipids are formed of fatty acid and glycerol. Proteins of amino acid and nucleic acids of nucleotides. We will be studying each of these macromolecules individually, one by one. So we'll be starting with carbohydrates first. Carbohydrates, or known as saccharides, they are commonly known as the sugars. If we look into the Greek, the saccharin means the sugar. So most of the thing have been derived from the Greek language. So carbohydrates or saccharides are actually commonly known as sugar. Basically, they are aldehyde or the ketone compounds with multiple hydroxyl group. So you know what is an aldehyde is, what a ketone group is, isn't it? This is the basic chemistry.
Ma'am.
I'm not going to detail. So with aldehyde,
yes,
and ketone, we have some hydroxyl group, and they are actually forming the carbohydrates. And carbohydrates are actually the most of the, or they are the most abundantly found, because they are most of the organic matter on the earth are form of carbohydrates. Now, some bullet points about carbohydrates, which is very much necessary. Carbs actually provide energy. So next time when your mother tells you to eat rice and all, so do not avoid it. Okay, so you are getting some energy. Yes, because they are the best source of fuel for the body. They also help us to digest the proteins and the fat. But again, there are pros and cons. So if you eat more of the carbohydrates that are needed for your energy, so that extra amount of carbohydrates, it's stored in the liver or the tissue as the fat. Right? Are you getting my point? So, jitna chahiye utna hi khaiye. Don't eat excess of the carbohydrates, but until unless else it will be stored as your fat in your tummy and you will be looking, I mean, you will be again scared for your calories. Okay, so carbohydrates, how they are produced? So mostly carbohydrates are produced through photosynthesis in plants. I guess all of you are aware of this typical reaction where carbon dioxide and water molecules interact with the energy and then release of glucose with the oxygen. So basically typical photosynthesis reaction. And that is the reverse one is the respiration, which actually we breathe the without the carbon dioxide. So carbohydrates are also the major source of energy from our diet, and CnH2n is this is the ratio how carbon, hydrogen and oxygen are actually present in the carbohydrates. Someone already told us, right? CnH2n, this is the typical formula of how a carbohydrate formula is there, composition. Yes, so if you look into the different categories of carbohydrates, so basically they are classified as monosaccharides, disaccharides, oligosaccharides and polysaccharides. So monosaccharides means the basic ones, there is no hydrolysis, this is the simple carbohydrates. Okay, so they are actually the monomers, how the carbohydrates form. Disaccharide, what happens that when two monosaccharides actually interact to form a disaccharide. So two monosaccharides are there to form a disaccharide. Oligosaccharide, actually 2 to 10 monosaccharide interact or they find to form a oligosaccharide. And then we have polysaccharide where more than 10 monosaccharide units interact to form a polysaccharide, or the we can see the carbohydrates. Clear? Class? Okay till now?
Yes, ma'am.
Carbohydrates, yes, ma'am.
So again, this is a tabular form where I have shown you the carbohydrates, the monosaccharide, 1 sugar molecule, disaccharide, 2 sugar molecule, oligo is for 2 to 10 and polysaccharide, 10 or more sugar molecules. So basically in my class, I will be in this session, I will be going through these categories, the marks, the ones that are marked in the red one. So you'll be learning about more about the monosaccharides, which are glucose, fructose and galactose. Under the disaccharides, which are actually composed of 2 sugar molecules, we'll be learning about sucrose, lactose and maltose. And among the polysaccharide, we'll be discussing about the starch, glycogen and cellulose. Okay. And there are many more monosaccharides, there are other disaccharides, oligosaccharides and all that we are not going to discuss. But if you are interested, you should learn about it. Okay. There are very good books. But for the time being, in our session, in this class, I will be teaching you this many. So starting with the monosaccharides or the simple sugar. So carbohydrate that cannot be hydrolyzed or that cannot be slitted into any smaller carbohydrate is a monosaccharide. So it's the basic building unit to which carbohydrates are formed. So monosaccharides are the simplest sugar. They are actually the 9 carbon atoms. Mostly they are having a carbonyl group, okay, which can be a keto group or a aldehyde group. And there are several hydroxyl groups, as you can see over in this chemical composition. And as you say, CnH2nOn is the chemical formula of this. So, yes. So, monosaccharide, actually, if you categorize them, so there are 2 forms. They can be aldose or a ketose, as I said. So aldose monosaccharide are something which are having an aldehyde group and obviously many hydroxyl groups, and ketose monosaccharide is having a ketone group and obviously many hydroxyl group. So this is how it looks like. This is a typical aldose, how it looks like. So you can see this aldehyde group, CHO group is formed like this. And in keto group, we have this C double bond oxygen keto group, and obviously we have 5-6. So based on the carbon atoms, they are named accordingly. So if I have here in this left hand picture, I have how many carbon atoms? We have around 4 carbon atoms. So this is a tetrose. So if I have 3 carbon atoms, so it is a triose. If it has 4, then it is a tetrose. Then it is a 5, pentose. And then we have 6, then hexose and all that. Okay. So since it is having 4 carbon atoms, it is a tetrose. And since it is having a aldehyde group, it is a aldotetrose. Similarly, over here, there are 6 carbon atoms in the right hand side picture. So it is a hexose. And since it is having a keto group, it is a ketohexose. By then again, they are having different names. So this aldotetrahydrose is named as erythrose, and this ketohexose is known as fructose. Okay. So yes, we go for simplest aldose. The simplest aldose is glyceraldehyde, and the simplest ketose is dihydroxyacetone. I guess these things you have learned in your chemistry as well. Isn't it? Or not?
Yes, ma'am.
So you are all aware of aldehyde and dihydroxyacetone structures as well. You can see the CHO group of aldehyde, and you can see the keto group in the dihydroxyacetone. The chemical formula for both of them is same. C3H6O3, like CnH2n and On, isn't it? But only the conformational differences because of the functional group. So these are known as the constitutional isomers. The constitution is same, but they are having different groups. So they are known as constitutional isomers. Yes, there are some important monosaccharides. As I told you beforehand, that we'll be discussing about 3 major monosaccharides, glucose, fructose, and galactose. So starting with the glucose, which is also known as dextrose.
One doubt is there.
Yes,
ma'am, in the previous slide, yes, ma'am, are they not functional isomers? Why constitutional?
Yes, you can say that also.
Oh. Yeah.
So, functional. So we are talking about the glucose, which is also known as a dextrose. It's a aldohexose. So this is one of the most evident monosaccharide. I guess all of you are aware of glucose. So it is found in fruits, vegetables, corn syrup, honey, etc. And also it forms a disaccharide known as sucrose, also lactose and maltose. This is common in all these 3 disaccharides. We will be learning about disaccharides soon. So if you look into disaccharides, so sugar is a major component of these 3 disaccharides, like sugar, lactose and maltose. And also sugar is the main constituents of the different polysaccharides such as starch, cellulose and glycogen. So this is the structure of glucose. It's a aldohexose, so 6 carbon atoms are there, and it's having a aldehyde group, CHO group is there. Okay. Now coming to the another monosaccharide, which is fructose, which is again having the same formula as glucose, 6 carbon atoms with double hydrogen and oxygen are 6. So fructose, as I said, is a ketohexose, so we having a ketone group. Okay. In glucose we had a aldehyde group, and in fructose we are having a keto group. So this is the sweetest of all the carbohydrates, and it is found in fruit juices and honey, so also known as the fruit sugar. And in the bloodstream, what happens is that this fructose is actually converted into the isomer, its isomer, which is glucose. Okay. And also fructose and glucose combine together to form a disaccharide known as the sucrose. We'll be studying soon. So these are about the fructose. So glucose and fructose are actually isomers. One is having aldehyde group and one is having keto group, and they are having the same chemical formula, C6H12O6. So we have another aldohexose known as galactose, which is actually also a aldohexose in the sense that it is also having an aldehyde group. It has all the structure similar to glucose, except that at the 4th carbon atom, you can see the OH, 1, 2, 3, 4. So you can see the how this is OH is formed in galactose, and you can see over here. in glucose and the fourth carbohydrate we have hydroxyl group on this side, and on galactose we have on the this side. So for the OH group, the structure that is a typical difference between the glucose and galactose. So galactose is actually, we do not see them in the free form in the nature. So they exist in the cellular membranes of the brains and the nervous systems. It actually combines, and for the disaccharides, so galactose actually combines with glucose to form the lactose, which is actually the sugar that is found in the milk. It's actually disaccharide. We'll be learning more about that. So glucose, fructose, galactose, all these three have the same chemical formula. Glucose and fructose, how they are different? Because of the aldo group and the keto group. And how glucose and galactose are different?
4-APMR. C4-APMR.
C4 position is different.
Yes, different. But both are aldohexoses. Okay. So clear for this time? I mean, for all the monosaccharides? Any doubt till now? Glucose, fructose, galactose? Yeah. Confused to nahi ho gaya? Okay. Okay. So why I am focusing more and asking you these things, that see, ek bar aap class mein pad lo, then you go revise it once and make your notes, whatever. Ek din mein at least 10 minutes aap de do, whatever you are studying. At the night you go make some notes. So what it happens that jo padhe usko revise ek bar kar lijiye. So it will so happen that in when you are writing for the exams, aapko isse zyada mehnat nahi karni padegi. Are you getting my point? So ye chote chote cheez hai, and ye to easy tha, pad liye, confident, over confident ho jata hai, fir bachche mistake kar dete hain. So ye wala cheez ko dhyan rakhiye, and just at least give 10 minutes. I'm not going for 1 hour or half an hour and all that. Just 10 minutes ek bar revise kar lijiye whatever you have studied, make some notes, because that will be very much useful for you for your end sem exams and also for midterm. Yeah,
PDF milega na ma'am?
Sorry,
PDF iska?
Ma'am, you
have
muted.
Ma'am, you have muted yourself.
Okay, Aditya is raising something, raising his hand. Aditya, any questions? Aditya, no? Okay. Again, he has raised. Okay, so what I was telling, we are discussing about the monosaccharides. So monosaccharides, the three monosaccharides are done. Moving to the this is something important. The sugar molecules actually tend to form a ring structure in the water. So what happens in aqueous solution, this aldehyde or the ketone group of the sugar tend to react with the hydroxyl group of the C molecule, thereby forming a closed ring like structure. You can look into this. So what is happening over here, the second one, this is the structure that we learned. And what is happening, that this aldehyde group or the ketone group is actually interacting over here to so they again react with this hydroxyl group of the same molecule to form this closed like ring like structures. Okay, so if you can write this structure or this structure also, you are getting marks in the exams. So whatever structure you write, you either write in the total form or like in the ring like structures. Okay, and you have to be careful with the numbering of the carbon atoms, because you are looking for the from the series, so that you have to be careful from where it is starting. Okay. Yeah, someone was asking about the isomers. So we know about isomers that they have the same chemical formula but different structures. And also, if they have the mirror images, they are also known as the optical isomers or the stereoisomers. So if you can, in sugars mostly we are having a lots of isomers things and all that. So stereoisomers actually the form is because of this mirror thing and all. So we can have D-glucose and L-glucose. So mostly they are differing, the isomers are differing their spatial arrangements of the atom molecules, because as I discussed earlier, glucose, galactose, also have mannose, they have actually the C same formula C6H12O6, but the different arrangement of the group atoms. So this is how the isomers are there. And when we look for the physical properties of the monosaccharides, so these are actually colorless, they are sweet, they are crystalline solids, they are actually polar with high melting points because we have hydroxyl groups. So they are actually polar, polar in the sense that they are hydrophilic or water loving, and they are having high melting points. Also, since polar, that means that they are hydrophilic, they are soluble in water and actually insoluble in non-polar solvent, all because of the hydroxyl groups. Clear? So these are some of the properties of the monosaccharides. We discussed about the structures. What three monosaccharides we discussed, class? Just a quick reminder. Class, am I audible?
Glucose, fructose, and galactose.
Yes, glucose, fructose, and galactose. So sometimes what happens that student may make mistakes like galactose ko disaccharide likh dete hai and then they forget what I don't know what happens. Glucose, fructose, galactose are monosaccharides. Galactose, remember, it's a monosaccharide and not a disaccharide. Yes. So what are actually disaccharides? So as I discussed, monosaccharides, when two monosaccharides form combine together, they form a disaccharide which are actually linked together with the help of a glycosidic bond. So remember, carbohydrates are actually bigger molecules, macromolecules. So the bond between the monomers in carbohydrates is the glycosidic bond. Okay. So glycosidic bond is a type of covalent bond. Actually, it is joining two or more monosaccharides to form the bigger molecules. So as I said, so what type of reaction over here it is taking place? With the release of water molecule?
Condensation reaction.
So water is released when molecules are, when two monomers are joining together. So there are three disaccharides that we are going to discuss in this class. There are many more. So maltose, lactose, and sucrose we will be discussing. So what are composition of maltose, lactose, and sucrose? So all these three have this common factor known as glucose. Again, in maltose, actually, there is another glucose molecule. So two glucose molecules interact to form a maltose molecule. In lactose, we have glucose and galactose. And in sucrose, we have glucose and fructose. Okay. So these are the monomers which are actually interacting to form this disaccharide bonds. And this with the release of a water molecule. And these are actually joined together with the help of a glycosidic bond. So do not get confused whenever exams questions comes, which is glycosidic bond, what is phosphodiester bond, and there are peptide bonds and all that. So people get confused and they just mess up with all these things and that will jump out of mark 0. So of these three disaccharides that we are going to study, maltose, lactose, and sucrose, maltose and lactose are actually the reducing sugar. Can anyone please tell me what are reducing sugar?
Which give a positive tolerance and failing test.
What tolerance and Benedict test positive, they are reducing sugar.
So in your chemistry classes, we have done this experiments. Benedict test.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good.
Yes, ma'am.
So, but last 2 years has been a pandemic year. So how did you do this chemistry experiments?
Not done. I am a dropper, ma'am.
Okay, so most of the people are droppers, so they have done, and those are freshers. They have seen through YouTube tutorials and the teachers performing soon.
Only done in theory, ma'am.
Sorry. I'm also class 11.
In class 11, you have studied. Okay, good. So these are good. I mean, chemistry experiments are fun, really fun. I loved it. So we have sucrose, which is actually a non-reducing sugar. So what is reducing and non-reducing, we'll be learning more detail. So reducing sugar actually is something that is actually capable of acting as a reducing agent. Okay, reducing agent in the sense that if this sugar actually has a free aldehyde or a free ketone group. So it acts as a reducing agent and hence it is named as reducing sugar. So if you look into monosaccharides, so all the monosaccharides have free aldehyde or ketone group, isn't it? So all the monosaccharides are actually reducing sugar. Okay. So since they have a pre-aldehyde or a ketone group. Among these disaccharides, we have maltose and lactose, which are reducing sugar. They are actually having one of their two enomeric carbons. We will look in the structures again. So they are actually involved in glycosidic bond. So they can convert, that's why, into an open chain form, also into an with an aldehyde group. Sucrose, on the other hand, is a non-reducing sugar, because what is happening here that the glycosiding bonds between this enomeric carbons, there are glycosidic bond, and they actually cannot convert into this open chain form with an aldehyde group. So okay, it is always into this cyclic form. So sucrose is not a reducing sugar. If you look into the structure, maltose is composed of two glucose molecules. So we have two alpha glucose are interacting here. You can see this is the closed chain form structure of glucose. So this first carbon and the fourth carbon actually forming a glycosidic bond. So what, how they are renaming this bond as, it, since it's alpha and the 1 and 4, so 1 comma 4, we are giving this carbon name, atoms which are actually interacting, and the 1 for glycosidic bond that is formed in the maltose with the release of a water molecule. So when we are looking for the bigger structure of the maltose, so these are actually obtained from the breakdown of the starches. So starch is a polysaccharide. We will be learning about starches. So starch, when it breaks down, it forms a maltose. And maltose, we are using them in cereals and candies and all that. As I told, this is a reducing sugar. You can see that the carbon 1, this one, can open to form a free aldehyde to oxidize. So this can open up, and this is a, that's why it's a reducing sugar. So it's already, I believe it's 11:45. Do you have any class right now, or can I take 10 more minutes?
Ma'am, we have classes from.
You have ma'am, we have classes after that.
Classes.
Electrical technology classes.
Sorry, electrical.
No, I am asking you, when do you have the class?
It is from
12. It's from 12. So what do you want me? You need a break? Should I stop over here and resume the class in the next one, or should we continue with this?
No, ma'am.
Please continue.
So I'm just finishing this disaccharides. That's over for today's class. So it will be useful for you only. So since we are going in a flow form, okay. So in a flow. So second disaccharide is lactose, which is formed of glucose and galactose. So whatever here it is, actually, it's a beta galactose and alpha glucose are interacting, so it will be a beta 1,4,1 and carbon, first carbon and fourth carbon are interacting, again 1,4 glycosidic bonds. And lactose actually is found in milk and milk products. It has, I don't know, almost no sweet, but again it is a reducing sugar, as I told you. So carbon 1 actually can open to form a free aldehyde to oxidize. Okay, so this is the milk sugar, the lactose. Then coming to the third one, which is the table sugar, which are actually we are eating every day, is the sucrose, which is actually obtained from the sugar canes and sugar beets and all that. So it is composed of two sugars, which are known as glucose and fructose. If you look into the structure over here, so the first carbon of glucose and the second carbon of fructose are actually forming this glycosiding bond. So it is a beta 1,2 glycosidic bond. Alpha sugar, alpha glucose and beta fructose are actually interacting to form a sucrose molecule. And you can look into the structure. This is a non-reducing. Why? Because this carbon atom, the first one, cannot open to form a free aldehyde to oxidize. Hence, it is a non-reducing agent or non-reducing.
Ma'am, here it is a doubt. Yeah. Ma'am, what does that mean? Carbon 1 cannot open to give free aldehyde to oxide. The criteria for distinguish between reducing and non-reducing sugar.
So you can see this bond, how this bond has been formed. So carbon ka yahan pe pura ka pura charo valency is occupied, isn't it? The structure is such a way that it cannot open to free aldehyde. Open up nahi ho raha hai to give it to into a oxidase.
So ma'am, in the previous slide where there was maltose, how it will open, and here it will not open.
There
should be a free hemiacetal group, right?
Yeah. They will be formed. If you look into this bonding, so it will open up to form a free aldehyde. I will show you the reaction next time when I have this pen paper. Okay. So I can just show you how it is actually happening, the reaction, because I don't have this pen thing over here right now to show you. Okay, in the next class I will be showing you how it is opening up, so that it is actually forming this free aldehyde group. It is giving the free aldehyde group, and that is why it is known as a reducing sugar. Here it is bonded and it is not giving the free aldehyde. Clear? So in the next class, remind me, I will just show you. I will just put on this pen, and in the MS Paint, I will show you that reaction. Okay? Okay, class?
Yeah.
So polysaccharides, polysaccharides thing we will be discussing, because again, we have some more classes in this year. Yeah. Polysaccharide, let's keep it here only. So that we'll start in the next class. We need to learn more in the details. So till now, monosaccharides and disaccharides. Any doubts, class?
No, ma'am.
What you are supposed to do, you go through some chemistry, it's a biochemistry book, okay? And just make some notes and all that, so that it will be useful for you only, so that you can appear for your exams. And
are you uploading this in file section?
Yeah, I will be uploading, but I will be uploading